Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Lena, I'm historian and video anthropologist. And today, on the eve of summer solstice, or if you are from Australia or South America, on the eve of winter solstice, I would like to tell you how to get the ideal partner, or why do Mr. Putin came to Russian Stonehenge, and what is it? So let's come with me to the trip to the Russian Stonehenge, Arkaim. And I want to notice that all the shootings on this video are mine. I have been shooting there in, as I remember, almost 5 years ago. So the Arkaim was discovered in 1987 when the group of archaeologists went to the southern Ural, to the Chelyabinsk region, to examine the value of the valley, in archaeological way, because this area would have been flooded. And on this area, some archaeological objects, some archaeological constructions have been already discovered, but they consider it not so important for the science, and so that's why after that was the really great fight between the Ministry of Water Resources of the USSR on this time and the scientists. And interesting that the scientists won, and if you won, you can learn about this situation somewhere, because it was really interesting. It was the paradox in some kind, because the collapse of the country in this exact situation was rather advantage, and so on. So the scientists won. Human burials, pottery, tips of arrows, chariot, and even the 11 iPhone were found here. I hope you understand that about iPhone is a joke. They date Arkaim to the beginning of the second millennium before Christ. And for that distant time, Arkaim was a very developed city, where metal was cast, storm sewers worked, and ancient people used the settlement as observatory. And after that, a lot of specialists from USA, Holland, or excuse me, Netherlands, and Germany became interested into Arkaim. But maybe the most important, the some kind of turning point of the Arkaim was in 1991, when the Tamara Globa, a well-known Russian psychologist and astrologist, went to the Arkaim, and she was walking around these beautiful hills and on this sunset, and she declared that the Arkaim is a place of power. And you know, guys, it was 90s, it was Dashen 90s. If you want, you can see my video about it. And this time, all kind of astrologists, esoterics, and mystics was extremely, extremely popular in our country, because it was quite pretty new for at least wide audience, and the law about censorship was closed. So after this situation, after this visit, all kind of healers, magos, witches, wizards, and you know, all these people who are from Hogwarts or Ilvermonti, let's name them like that, came to the Arkaim. And in 2005, Arkaim visited, guess who? Mr. Putin. He met personally with the chief archaeologist, Геннадий Зданович. But even presidents have their innermost desires and rumors that he came to the Hill of Power and wished to stay eternal president of Russia. If it's so, it still works very well. But back to the magic day of the summer solstice. In the pre-Christian era, this day the Slavs called it Kalvarot or the day of Ivan Kupala, and I know that it likes Estonian Jaanipäev. It was believed that on this day water and fire gain healing powers. So people burned bonfires, bathed in ponds and rivers. They spent all nights singing songs, dancing and meeting the sunrise. And on this solstice eve, girls make their wreaths from flowers and herbs and drop them not into but onto the water. And if the wreaths come to the other shore, that means that the girl get married in a year. But if the wreaths drawn into the water, that means that the girl will stay single and unmarried for a long, long time. That is also not bad, so that's why it is a controversial question who of these two girls are more fortunate. And nowadays you can also see the people who are sitting and meditating on the hill of love for a best, for an ideal future partner. And you know, I don't want to name these people like weird and to laugh on them, because I do appreciate that now I have this unique opportunity to observe this this phenomenon, this interesting process which is happening right now.
And who knows, maybe it works. Please come to your own solstice and check. Arkaim is open to representatives of all religions and beliefs. For example, the Krishnaites sing songs all night and dance in a large column up to Mount Shamanka.
And of course, people make the most important wish for help to themselves and the health of close people, seeing of the big orange sun.
Спи, мой малыш, вырастай на просторе, быстро промчатся года. Белым орленком на ясные зори ты улетишь из гнезда.
So thank you very much for joining me in this journey to the Russian Stonehenge, Arkaim. And in this magical eve, I want to wish you love and prosper, health and success. Please subscribe to my channel. It was Lena and my unforgettable Russian accent.